Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.4.1 has been out for a few days, as well as iOS 14.5 beta 3, which has been out for a couple of weeks. And so I want to talk about the overall experience, battery life, the remaining issues, and whether or not you should install iOS 14.4.1 if you haven't already. Now the first thing is iOS 14.5 beta 3 has a new feature that's been found. I think it's the last thing that I've been able to find with it, and some people are seeing this, not everyone, but if you have a phone call and you've had a recent phone call or a missed phone call, you may get this notice at the top where it says silence unwanted calls. Now we've had that feature for quite some time, but it tells you a little notification about it. And also it looks like this the first time you open it. It will pop up on screen, full screen, and tell you to turn on call silencing if you want to reduce interruptions, for example. So that's something new that some people are seeing. I didn't see it on my phones, but some people are seeing this. Now, as far as iOS 14.4.1, we'll cover that first, and I'm running that on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. Now, if you enjoy these follow-ups, be sure to subscribe if you haven't done that already. That would be fantastic if you'd like to see more of these videos and the different sort of iPhone updates and reviews I do as well. Now, the first thing with iOS 14.4.1 is that it's actually been pretty good, depending on who you ask. Now, if you're looking for specific features, everything seems to be very similar to what you had with iOS 14.4. Some people are still seeing lags or lagging when you close the apps, for example. And so lag seems to be an issue for some, but in general, the performance has been great for most people. The overall experience has been really what you would expect. No real issues other than what you might have had with 14.4, but there are quite a few things that people mentioned that still sort of exist in this update that we're waiting for them to fix with iOS 14.5. For example, a lot of people are saying they don't notice anything, but there's quite a few people saying that they have issues with Bluetooth still. So if you're using AirPods and you're switching between iPhone and iPad, a lot of people are still having issues not only connecting to their iPhone, but just with Bluetooth in general, with third-party headphones and everything else. So there's definitely an issue here with Bluetooth. That's true on beta 3 as well with iOS 14.5. So there's some issues there. Some people are unable to download text messages as well. So there's some bugs there. I experienced that on 14.5 beta 3 today as well. So there's something going on with that. That could be on Apple's server side if we're using iMessage, for example, but there's something going on there. Also, green tint is not fixed with iOS 14.4.1, but is being fixed with 14.5. Many people have noticed a significant reduction in green tint, especially on dark screens when booting up, for example, with 14.5. So I think they'll continue to finish this or fix this before it's finished and released to the public. Now, as far as other issues, well, like I said, some people are still seeing lagging when you're closing apps, and some people are also saying that the phone is getting unreasonably hot. So it's getting overly warm, and that can reduce battery power, of course, if it's doing a lot of processing in the background, which would use the processor more and reduce the overall experience and cause it to lag. So some people are seeing excessive heat. That's not a lot of people, but there's definitely people mentioning it with this update. And then finally, people are saying Safari has been slow for them on and off. So sometimes Safari works great. Sometimes it doesn't. If I go into it now, you'll see I'm on the Apple website. Let's see how fast it is here. It seems to be okay. Of course, some of this can be due to your overall connection, whether that be through Wi-Fi or 5G or 4G, depending on what device you're using. But some people are seeing that sort of poor experience with Safari on 14.4.1. So overall battery life on iOS 14.4.1 is actually okay, depending on who you ask. Now we'll take a look at the comments a little bit later, but 55% of you are saying that it's better based on the comments on the community poll. So 55% are saying it's the same, you didn't notice anything, or it's better or significantly improved. 45% of you are saying that it's not as good and it's very poor. Generally, the people that are saying that it's not good are having issues with it getting warm or have just installed it. Usually it will take a couple days to sort of stabilize, and others have been saying battery health has gone down. Now, generally when it goes down from say 99%, this is my 11 Pro Max that I used full time for a year, and it went down to 93%. It's normal to go down, not from updates, but just the overall degradation of the physical battery. So every time you install an update, it rechecks what it is, and this will go down over time. Unfortunately, until batteries have a new formulation and someone comes out with a better battery, this is going to happen. This happens on Android. And in fact, in many cases, when people use fast charging a lot on Android with some of the very fast chargers, I've seen this degrade much more quickly on, say, an Android phone, as opposed to, say, an iPhone. But it just depends on which phone you're using, how you're charging it. But generally, 80% after 2 years is normal. If you fast charge all the time, it may degrade a little bit more quickly. I tend to charge this overnight all of the time. Now, overall battery on 14.4.1, I wanted to show you some real world usage. So I took a screenshot from my wife's phone. She's got an iPhone 12 Pro. It's been charged every night wirelessly, every single night when it needs to charge. And if she's in the car, she charges it as well on a wireless charger. Her battery health is 100%. That's pretty normal if you do that sort of charging. I find that leaving it on the charger overnight is not a problem, especially because we have optimized battery charging, which brings it up to 80%, holds it there, and then finishes to 100% before you get up, usually in the morning, take it off the charger and you're ready to go. But either way, before they had that, I always charged it overnight and didn't have too much of an issue with that. Her battery life overall, you can see this day, this was yesterday, she got 2 hours and 43 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 35 minutes of screen off time, and used about 50% of her battery, maybe a little bit less. So she's getting about 5 hours of screen on time with this phone. That's if she was to use 100% of her battery. I took a look at the next day, you'll see 4 hours and 20 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 1 minute of screen off time at almost 75% of her battery. So day to day, it varies quite a bit, but 5 to 6 hours is pretty normal with an iPhone 12 Pro. And so I'd say that's pretty decent battery life. She hasn't been complaining about it and hasn't had any issues there. Now with iOS 14.5 beta 3, well, I've been running that full time on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. The iPhone 11 also has it, and my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. And so the overall experience here, I went over in detail a week or so ago, but one thing I consistently see over and over, which I left on the iPhone 11, is if you reboot the phone and you go into your settings, you'll see that you'll have to update Apple ID settings. I see this over and over with a reboot. A lot of people are complaining about it, and it's something I've seen regularly if you reboot it on the beta. It's really annoying because you have to sign back in every time, and it's not a huge issue other than that it's more of an annoyance than anything else. Other people are saying that handoff isn't working, and I'm experiencing the same thing. If you're using handoff from your iPhone to a HomePod mini, for example, it just doesn't work. So here is my HomePod mini, and when I try and bring the phone near it, handoff just doesn't work anymore. I suspect they'll fix this with the next one. But also, I have the HomePod mini betas running on here, and stereo pairing doesn't work right. Sometimes you can request something from Siri, and for whatever reason, it only plays in one of them if they're stereo paired. Sometimes it doesn't play at all. If I AirPlay from my phone to them, it doesn't work right. So there's definitely some issues with it, and I hope they fix that fairly soon. I've had issues with touch from time to time, and others are having issues with the phone crashing, apps not really lagging so much. When you're closing out an app, it seems to be okay most of the time. You saw a little bit of frame rate stutter there, so it's not perfect, but it is beta 3, and hopefully they'll fix this with future releases. But another issue is with MagSafe. I hear this a lot, but my phones experience this as well. If we turn the screen off and you're using an iPhone 12 series phone, put on MagSafe, it charges, but you don't get the animation that was really nice before. I imagine they'll bring this back in a future update as they know it's broken. And I've seen some feedback from those of you that have reported it and let me know. And many people are saying their feedback is being acknowledged for these issues that I'm mentioning to you. So hopefully we'll see these resolved very soon. Apple's acknowledged them and said they'll be fixed in future updates. So I would expect those to be fixed by the final release for sure. Also, notifications still are an issue for some. I'm actually not having an issue. Notifications work on Instagram for me, for example, but some are still seeing that issue. And if you are, I would recommend reinstalling that application since they seem to be coming in without a problem. Other than that, there's a couple little weird glitches here and there with touch stopping and not working. Sometimes you can touch in an app and scroll, but you can't touch on a link, for example. And then again, Bluetooth, like I said. So lots of things that are going on with this beta. And as far as the overall usage of it, it seems to be okay and performance is fine, but it's got some weird bugs in it, which you want to report in feedback. Now, like I said, battery life on 14.4.1 is good for most people, but a lot of people are saying that battery life on beta 3 is decent as well. It's not always great for everyone, but that usually comes down to what apps you're using. So if I go into my settings, for example, we'll go over to settings, go to battery, Battery health on my 12 Pro Max is still 100%. And like I said, I charge my phones overnight every night, and we'll go to the last 10 days and we'll take a look at yesterday. So yesterday I used 50% of the battery or so and had 4 hours and 13 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 16 minutes of screen off time, playing music and things like that. The day before, I used 2 hours. Now I'm getting about 8 to 10 hours of screen on time with the 12 Pro Max. I recently turned off some notifications that were popping up on my screen and making my screen light up. So I should see some improvements over the next few days, but in general, I would say it's decent battery life. As you can see here, I had 3 hours and 16 minutes a few days ago and only used a quarter of the battery life. So if we times that by 4, we'd have about 12 hours of screen on time, which is quite good. So it just depends on how you're using your phone. So I think it's pretty good there. Now, iPadOS 14.5 Beta 3 continues to have subpar battery life for me. So if I go to the settings, for example, and go to battery, we'll wait for it to load. You can see it was last charged yesterday or a couple days ago at 4:51 PM to 100%. Since then, it's only been used a couple hours and it really drains very fast. So 5 hours of screen on time on a beta is okay. Somebody said that's unacceptable, and it is if this was a public release, but this is a beta having this issue. And so if this continues with the public release, I'll completely wipe this device and start over and see if that fixes it. You can see my home and lock screen continue to be something that pops up a lot. So I need to fix that, make sure those notifications stop as they're making the screen sort of light up. However, the overall experience on the iPad is quite good. I've had zero issues with this whatsoever, whether that be with the Magic Keyboard or any of these updates. It seems to be working really well. Other than battery life, it's been really great. It's not warm. Everything's working great. It's just that battery life in general. Now, should you install iOS 14.4.1? Well, I would say for the security issues alone, I would install it, since you're going from 14.4 to 14.4.1, which patches a major security flaw. So I would update just for that, just for the security of it, but you really won't see much of a difference after a couple of days. If you give it a few days, let it sort of do its thing in the background, make sure all the apps are sort of not really indexing, it's not trying to find anything, and also be sure to check your battery to make sure that there's something not using it excessively. So make sure you update that and it should be pretty good. But that security update is major, so I'd make sure you update for that reason. Now, as far as iOS 14.5 Beta 4 or release candidate, I was quite surprised we didn't see one this week. So based off that, I would expect one probably as soon as next week. So I thought for sure we'd have one this week. Apple has been very unpredictable in 2021, so it seems like they're still unpredictable. In fact, I expected an announcement for WWDC 2021 today, since last year they announced it on the 13th, which was Friday last year. So this is close enough that I thought we'd see an announcement for WWDC 2021 in June, where we'll see iOS 15 for the first time and get iOS 15 Beta 1. That'll be released to developers and public beta testers a little bit after that, with a final release in September of iOS 15 generally. But this year, like I said, they've been unpredictable. So this coming week, I would expect an update either on Monday or Tuesday with a release candidate at this point, since it's rumored that there's going to be an event on the 23rd. And if Apple does have an event on the 23rd, usually we'll get the release candidate the week before or so. We could have a beta 4. They could even release it at this point, since they've really changed things up. But I think we'll see a beta 4 or release candidate early next week, given that they didn't release anything this week so far. So that's what I'm really thinking they're going to do. But like I said, they've been unpredictable for quite some time. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll, before we take a look at that, here are the statistics about what people mentioned when it comes to battery life, lagging, freezing, heat, and crashing. So this is how many people mentioned it, and where I get the battery numbers from iOS 14.4.1, for example, are I take all of these 101 comments or so, go through them individually, and then see how many people say it's good or bad or the same. So that's how I get all this information. It's straight from you, with different people having different experiences with different apps. Here's all the devices people are using at the time of the poll. And so as you can see, the iPhone 11 is one of the most used, as well as the 12 Pro Max. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now, as you can see at the time of this video, there's 14,000 votes. And as you can see, 56% of you said that it's great. 5% say that it's terrible. 12% say okay, but some bugs. 13% are using the betas. And someone said earlier today that they were surprised that they thought more people on this would be using the beta than they are, but not that many people use betas usually. And then 14% are using Android. So that number actually went up this week. You can also see the same statistics for iOS 14.5 beta 3, for example, with 34,000 votes. So if you want to take a look at those, I leave all of these polls here if you want to look at them yourself on the community page. Now there's 356 comments at the time of this video. Let's go ahead and sort those and take a look at some of them. Now, as you can see here, Maurice Kennedy said, still no notification for SMS messages. Happy and Snappy said, it's been great on my iPhone 7 Plus. If we go down a little bit, you'll see PS said, I would advise not to install 14.4.1. It has major bugs, but this seems to be the minority from what I'm seeing. But again, it depends on what apps you're using and more. Mr. Sim says, iPhone 11 Pro Max on iOS 14.4.1, no issues, working great. Kofi Lord said, not as good as 14.4 and sometimes camera froze when you want to snap. Abhishek PR says, having app closing lag issues more frequently now. There seems to be an issue with phone call and WhatsApp calls where I can't seem to use the latter if I immediately finish a phone call and try to place a WhatsApp call. Bluetooth connectivity when receiving a call still remains where I have to manually select my Bluetooth headset as an audio option instead of automatically selecting Bluetooth. Not great for me. Jixer Rider says, iOS 14.4.1 has been great on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. Luke Sullivan said, it's been amazing on iPhone 11. Battery life is amazing as well as performance. And as you can see already, there's a stark contrast in people having issues with battery versus people having a great experience with battery. XO says, I'm on iPhone 7 with iOS 14.4.1. With iOS 14.4 was a bit of lag, but now I haven't experienced any lag. I think it's all right, but still I have a problem with the battery. Pranoy, if I'm saying that correctly, says the battery performance has been great so far and I'm zero stutters. I'm using iPhone 11. Jacare's One Way Solution says for iPhone 11, it's great. The phone battery has improved much more and no lag anymore. Hope iOS 14.5 will work the same as this minor update 14.4.1. Vishrut Vatsa says weird app icon getting stuck every time I'm changing home screens after swiping up from an app. Also, the OLED panel is not turning off on dark backgrounds, and it still exists. That also should be fixed in iOS 14.5. Eldo says, my SE2 loses internet signal. Juan Espinoza says, iOS 14.4.1 has been very good on my iPhone 11, and battery life is very good as well. The only problem I'm getting my mail notifications 2 hours later than the time they were sent. So definitely an issue, and I saw some of that with the beta as well. Shrivam Krishan Agrawal, hopefully I said that right. I'm noticing the raise to wake feature sometimes isn't working as good as it was on 14.4, noticing that there is some delay. Nikki says, I'm using iOS 14.4.1 on my iPhone 10 and it's really good so far. Battery life seems to have improved a bit over 14.4 because I barely have standby battery loss overnight anymore, and performance also feels a bit smoother than on iOS 14.4. Can't wait for iOS 14.5 though. Great video as always, Aaron. Thank you. And like I said before, there's a stark contrast between some people having great battery life and a great experience and no drain overnight to people having really bad drain. Dennis W says, okay so far on my SE 2020 and iPad 6th gen. iOS 14.4.1 lagging so much on my iPhone SE 2016 and Files apps crashing when I select a large number of text. And let's take a look at one more. My iPhone is flickering while watching video content like movies or shows. The blacks flicker gray, and when using the volume bar, the top of my screen turns gray. I hope it's a software issue because I've had this phone for less than a week. First iPhone since iPhone 5S. And that particular issue is being addressed with iOS 14.5. Many have said that it's fixed already in most situations. So hopefully you'll see that in a week or two at this point. And that's it for iOS 14.5, Beta 3, and iOS 14.4.1. I'm really looking forward to the public release of 14.5, and even more so to iOS 15. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.